Hi, I'm James Adams. I'm here on behalf of expertvillage.com, and I'm going to talk to you about PCI Express video cards. PCI Express actually has a 16 at the end, or is spelled PCIe X16, and this is the latest technology to play games. This is a PCI Express video card, PCI Express 16, and it's actually a pretty good one. It's a 7600, which is pretty good for games. Notice how the socket is about an eighth of an inch longer than the AGP. So that's a physical difference on the cards themselves. The advantages for the PCI Express is the newest technology, so you don't have to worry too much about being outdated and stuff. So if your motherboard can support a PCI Express, you can just about drop any card in the market. Some PCI Express cards are so powerful that they need their own, they have their own socket for a power connector. Okay, so a PCI Express card sometimes will have its own power connector. And this is what a power connector looks like. It's got three things on the bottom and three things on the top, and it goes on the video card. But when you do that, your power supply and your computer needs to be at least 400 watts, if not more. And it depends on the video card how powerful of a power supply you'll need. PCI Express is great for gaming, is great for video editing and doing 3D graphics and such. But if your computer has a PCI Express slot on it and you just need it for doing email and typing letters, chances are the built-in video of your computer is good enough that you don't really need a video card. So if you're just gonna type emails and write letters, do your homework for school, and you have a PCI slot and you're thinking it's running slow, I need a PCI card, video card, just don't do it because you won't really use it. Spend the money and buy more RAM for your computer or buy a new hard drive. But unless you're planning on games and video editing, get a PCI Express card. There are different kinds and technologies, and I'll proceed to explain that later. Thank you.